to you, the secretary of the Hanson Little League, Mr. Paul Clark. All right, I want to welcome you all today. Thank you for coming. Looks like a big speech, but as the years have gone on, the font's getting a little bit bigger for me, so I got it at 18 font this year. I want to welcome everyone here to the annual Little League Opening Day Parade. I'm going to be grabbing applause, everyone. This will be followed by our annual Family Fun Day. And this year, once again, we are happy to welcome the girls softball from Hanson. We have a bunch of activities planned for the rest of the day, so I hope you can stay with us. We caught a break today. It finally feels like spring is here. The weather's beginning to improve a little bit. We're getting ready for another exciting year of Hanson baseball and softball. I know the players, coaches, and the entire league are eager to start. And we want to thank all the volunteers and the sponsors of both of our leagues. Many of them are advertised in the back here with their signs. We thank you for your ongoing support of this program. But for today, we want to give some special thanks. Once again, the call goes out. We always know it's going to be yes. The best DJ in the South Shore, John Zucco. We'd also like to thank from McLaughlin Chevrolet, Dan Adams. They donated all this catcher's gear, some money, they got some signs, so we got all new catcher's gear for the young kids. And Dan's son is a new firefighter in town. We also want to thank Mike's Pizza, Country Rentals, that donated all the blow-up games. Venus 3, the Hanson Highway Department, led by Bob Brown, the Hanson Police and Fire. Today would be a day to commit a crime because I think half the police force is here today. We'd also like to thank the Community Preservation Committee. They're the ones who are responsible for getting the money for the improvements on the fields. You can see the fields are in really good shape this year. We had a lot of construction going on. We want to thank them for all the hard work that they do. We also want to thank the Hanson Parks and Fields who are doing a great job of keeping up the maintenance for the fields. Our mission here at the Hanson Little League is pretty simple. It is to create a safe environment for your children to play in and learn the game of baseball. But more importantly, we want them to have fun and we want them to learn how to be good sports. Good sportsmanship is something that we've always emphasized with the kids, and we usually have a great amount of good kids, and we've never had any issues, and we just want to emphasize that this is all for fun. So when the parents this year, especially for the minor leagues, this is something I wanted to say, there are kid umpires. No one is going to be promoted to the Boston Red Sox this year. So there's a zero tolerance policy for any parents and even some grandparents to be yelling at the umpires. To give you a little perspective about the growth of our league, the league first began with Donnie Ford, 1953. We're now celebrating our 64th consecutive year. And at that time, we only had three teams in total for the whole league. Today, we have over 300 kids playing in the program with over 29 teams. And we continue to have overwhelming support in all of our leagues, including the instructional leagues where we have T-ball for 4-, 5-, and 6-year-olds. Peewees for the 7- and 8-year-olds. We get the minor and major league divisions as well as a senior league division. This year we're very close to the same number that we had last year, and even though we have a lot of competition from different sports, we're still able to get the same amount of kids to come out, which we want to thank you, especially all the parents. And Amy Cornetta said, especially the mothers. We want to especially thank all the mothers. And we continue to have great participation in our summer programs with a lot of good success over the years. So we hope to keep that tradition going this year. And similar to the other sports in town, Hanson Little League is run entirely by volunteers. We appreciate all of you who continue to volunteer your time and energy to the programs. I want to give a good shout out to Karen Scanlon this year, who's taken over the Snack Shack. I hope she loses my phone number and email because she's been on the phone with me about 100 times this week. But the snack shed's going to be awesome this year. We got some new items. So you'll really want to come down and Don't make dinner plans. We'll have a lot of good stuff here. And again, without all of the parents' support, we wouldn't be successful. We do have a number of fundraising events that are scheduled to assist with the ongoing expenses of maintaining the fields. Some of our fundraising events coming up, we do have a 50-50 raffle today. Last year's winner won about $300. I know no one wants to think about the fall yet, but we have our annual Damien's Road Race, which raised $4,500 last year for Hanson Little League. So we'll be sending out emails probably in July or August for you to sign up for that. And then we also have our annual raffle tickets that you purchased. The drawing will be announced later on, not today, but later on in the season. We'll send you an email for that. The winner of that gets $2,500. Again, all of these fundraising activities allow us to try to keep the registration fees down. And believe it or not, there is, even though we have new fields and new community money, it still costs a lot of money to keep the fields up. At this time, we would like to welcome Father Lee to give us a blessing.
Lord, we sing your praises without ceasing. You rule over all things with wonderful order. You temper our cares and burdens of our thought. And by giving us rest and healthy recreation, you refresh our weary bodies and minds. We entreat your kindness that this place and its facilities will contribute to leisure activities that renew the spirit and strengthen mind and body. Grant that all who meet here may find the enrichment of companionship, the strengthening of the virtues of fair play and sportsmanship, and together offer you the praise that is your due. We ask you to bless these our young people, their parents and coaches, and all who are present. Amen. God bless you all.
Okay, we have a great lineup today for opening day. And we're gonna start with a tradition that we had for many years. Unfortunately, we lost Father Mark a few years ago, but John Zucco was able to capture this on tape. So opening day would not be opening day if we didn't have a rendition of God Bless America from Father Mark.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountain to the prairie to the ocean, white with foam. God bless America, my own sweet home.
All right, Father Mark delivered a great day for us. Right now, we would like to recognize the Hanson Little League Board. First of all, it's led by our president, Mike Jocelyn. And the other board members, many of them are coaches here today, Eric Olson, Don Ford, Greg Collins, Chris Walsh, Rob O'Brien, Rich Bergio, Paul Clark, Bill Braheny, Steve Gilcoin, Bill Dever, Dave Goldman, Kevin Leahy, Sean McKay, Jay Walker, and Chris Toscano. Now for what we're really here for, we're gonna introduce the teams and their coaches. We're gonna start with the T4 Stand Up A's. The A's are led by Michael Means. The next T4 team of the Red Sox, led by Michael Minasucci. Angels, I'm sorry, the Angels. Next up with T5, we got the A's. Managed by Bill Hinchy. The Cardinals, led by Joe Cornetta.
Get up, guys.
We got the Marlins, led by Mark Gomes. And we got the T5 Orioles, led by Chris Walsh. All right, T6, the A's. Managed by Eric Beltramini. We got the Cardinals, led by Eric Olson. We have the Marlins, led by Jay Walker. And the Orioles, led by Dave Scascia. All right, we got the Pee-wees. The A's are led by Rick Dockendorf. The Cubs, led by Bill Perhenny. The Giants, led by Dave Goldman. Out there, the Orioles. Dave, you didn't give me the updated list. We got the Red Sox, led by Ted Ross. The White Sox, led by Michael Means. And the Phillies, led by Rich Bergio. Now we go on the minors, the Angels, led by Pat Burke. The A's, led by Chris Toscano. The Cubs, managed by Dennis Carroll. The Orioles, led by Jay Walker. And the Tigers, led by Steve Gilcorn. They're the loudest, they take after their coach. Now we're going to the majors. The A's, led by Dennis Hawley. We got the Cardinals, led by Don Ford. We have the Orioles, led by John Burroughs. We've got the Rays, led by Joe Cornetta. And we got the Red Sox, led by Rich Bergio. All right, now we're gonna go to girls softball. We've got the instructional green team sponsored by Comfort Plumbing, led by Michael Hurley. We've got the instructional blue team, Jermaine Realty sponsor, led by Chris Walsh. We've got the instructional pink team sponsored by Fabiano Florist, led by Alicia Fabiano. And we got the instructional red team sponsored by Hanson Police, led by Amy Gavin. We've got the minor DTB custom carpentry team led by Brian Campbell. We've got the junior team sponsored by Hanson Fire, led by Joe Mead. And we've got the senior team sponsored by TG Installation, led by Tim Young. Okay, right now I'd like to introduce Kennedy Frazier here to do the national anthem.
and bright stars through the perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Awesome job, Kennedy. Great job, great job. Almost there. We just have a couple of announcements. For all of you throughout the season, you should be checking out HansonLittleLeague.com, where you can find out your kids' schedules, email addresses for your coaches, and sometimes we have some opportunities that come up. We have a great opportunity for the kids to get on the field at a Pawtucket Red Sox game on June 25th. We've got 150 tickets. They're going fast. It's on a first come, first serve. The kids will be able to go on the field before the game, and then you'll get some seats, and they also give you $4 food vouchers too. So the tickets are $10 and $8, and then you get the $4 food voucher. But it's a great opportunity for the kids. No parents on the field. Sorry about that. Just kids. But it's a great opportunity, and you'll have information, the email address. You'll be emailing me. I'll reserve them, and we just need the money in about 4 weeks. But you can at least put your name in for the tickets. It's going to be a great opportunity. All right, and don't forget, we're about to start the fun day. We have our annual Home Run Derby contest. We'll be signing up over there. It's $10 per person. We have a 9-year-old, 10-year-old, 11, and 12-year-old division, as well as for some of us who won't give up, an adult division too. Right now, it's time to award the Boteri Award winner. This award is named after Don Boteri, who this whole complex is named after. The winner of this award is a player who demonstrated through his years in the league to not only be a good player, but a great team player who epitomizes good sportsmanship. This is one of the first years that this player, we had numerous coaches nominate him, and it was a unanimous decision. We'd like to introduce the winner, Kyle Hunsinger. Applause for Kyle. Don't forget, we got our 50-50 raffle. We'll be coming around selling them. Like I said, last year won about $300. Right now, we would like to introduce two people to do the first pitch. For the baseball, we would like to welcome Ken Mitchell. Ken is the chairman of the Parks and Fields. He's a member of the Board of Selectmen. He's a member of the Community Preservation Committee. And most importantly, he's always been a great friend of Hanson Little League. Even before he had the twinkle in his eye to run for selectman, a job I don't know why anyone in their right mind would want to do in this town, but Kenny has always come down and helped us. You all set? You got your Bengay working? Great job, thank you, Kenny. And for softball, we would like to welcome Laura Kemet, chairman of the Community Preservation Committee. In a cooperative effort with the Town Forest Committee, and the parks and fields. She collaborated with our own Lieutenant Rob O'Brien here of the Hanson Fire, who wrote the grant to CPC, which allowed us to be awarded over $75,000 to renovate the major and minor league fields. The fields look great this year, and we want to thank Laura for her commitment to us. We'll be renovating the parking lot and also an entrance to the town forest in the upcoming months. But Laura, give it a whirl. Good job. All right, where's Aiden McKay?
Yeah, what are you doing?
I don't know, I got asked to do this. I haven't thrown a softball for years.
All right, the league is not officially christened until we say these two words.
Play ball!
All right, thank you all for coming out today. We hope you have a great season and a lot of activities planned for today, so please stick around, support the league. And most of all, have fun this year. Thank you again, and thank you, John Zucco, again. John, you are the best.
Thank you, Paul. Once again, it's a fun day. Let's have some fun.
Thank you.